Madam Speaker, our hawker centres are a unique and integral part of Singapore's identity. Not only do they serve an important function of providing affordable food in a clean environment, they are key social spaces where people from all walks of life can enjoy a meal together. The government had previously announced that 20 new hawker centres will be ready by 2027. This will add about 800 more food stalls across the island. I'm pleased to update that 3 new hawker centres have been completed so far, with the latest being our Tampines Hub, which commenced operations in November last year. As highlighted by Associate Professor Daniel Goh, NEA has been exploring alternative management models by engaging socially conscious operators, such as NTUC Food Fair, Face Young and OTMH, as managing agents for hawker centres. The feedback from both hawkers and patrons of these centres have been largely positive. NFC in particular is an established, socially conscious operator and has been managing the existing Bedok Interchange Hawker Centre since 2014. Rentals at these centres have remained unchanged and food prices have been kept largely stable. Besides monitoring food prices for affordability and ensuring that any price revision is justified, these operators have put in place initiatives like offering bulk purchase of ingredients to help hawkers reduce their costs, or putting in place productivity measures such as centralized dishwashing to help hawkers address their manpower constraints. Given the encouraging outcomes of these initial efforts, we have extended this approach to other hawker centres. We have appointed NFC to manage a group of 5 existing centres with incumbent stallholders and 2 new centres. Allowing NFC to manage a bundle of hawker centres will enable them to have the necessary scale to enhance the vibrancy and hygiene standards across more hawker centres, as well as the flexibility to experiment with new ideas and processes to benefit patrons and hawkers. This is the first expanded pilot, and we will need to evaluate the results of this approach before we decide on the next steps. We are calling for tenders for the 2 new centres at Yishun and Jurong West. The tenders are open to all socially conscious operators who are interested to manage the centres. We will select the best tender proposal to ensure that our hawker centres continue to fulfil the fundamental objective of providing affordable food in a hygienic environment while allowing our hawkers to make a decent livelihood. To Associate Professor Goh's query on subsidised rent in new centres, subsidised rents were offered to encourage street hawkers to relocate to hawker centres in the 1970s and early 80s. Some hawkers were also allowed to operate stalls at subsidised rents under the previous hardship scheme, which was discontinued in 1990. Since then, all new hawkers are required to pay rental at market rate. Hence, there are no subsidised rents in all our new centres. Last year, I announced the formation of a Hawker Centre 3.0 committee to review and make recommendations to improve the management of hawker centres and ensure the sustainability of the hawker trade to benefit Singaporeans. Following a year of extensive consultations with many stakeholders, including hawkers, patrons, cleaning service providers, and members of the public, the committee submitted the recommendations to the Minister in February this year. Mr. Liang asked about a response to the HC 3.0 committee's recommendations. I'm pleased to announce that the Ministry has accepted all the recommendations. We will therefore work together with relevant stakeholders to implement them. Let me highlight a few plans that we will put in place in the coming months. First, one key recommendation is for the government to provide training opportunities and pathways for aspiring hawkers, young or the not so young. For a start, we are working with the People's Association to develop a hawker fair series of culinary classes starting in May. Members of the public can learn how to cook hawker dishes like chicken rice, yong tau foo, and mee goreng from the veteran hawkers themselves. While not all trainees will eventually become hawkers, such courses will also help to generate interest in hawker food and culture among Singaporeans and contribute to sustaining the hawker trade in the long run. There are a handful of culinary certification courses in the market today. However, these courses are largely not tailored for the hawker trade. Hence, in addition to the Hawker Fair series that focuses on culinary skills, we are working with the ITE to develop a separate short course to teach aspiring hawkers relevant business management skills like basic profit and loss analysis and how to tender for a stall to help them set up and manage a hawker business. More details will be released later in the year. We welcome other interested parties, such as training providers, to work with us to provide appropriate training to aspiring hawkers. In the second half of this year, we will set up a one-stop information and service centre, which will provide useful information to both existing and aspiring hawkers, like how to tender for a stall, where to go for courses on food hygiene and the hawker trade, and the range of kitchen automation equipment available. During the second half of the year, we will also be launching an incubation stall program, where some hawker stalls at several hawker centres will be pre-fitted by NEA to let eligible aspiring hawkers try out being a hawker for a period of, say, 6 months. This will allow them to decide if they are cut out for the trade without having putting in heavy investments.